Hello everybody, my name is Werner Herzog and I will be playing a video game called Minecraft. This was popularly recommended to me by friends at the universities, a film that I have visited on my tour to promote my upcoming new film, Queen of the Desert. Now, video games, as you know, are symptomatic of the degradation of human society. So today, we will be indulging in that. So I have done a little background research on this game, Minecraft, and it is apparently a simulator of man versus nature, which is emblematic of our true purpose in society. For example, look at this pixelated dog. In no way is it a real dog. It is in fact false. This is emblematic of the fact that we as a society are depressed. What goes on in this dog's mind? Is it only coding? It must be. But we can only hope that there is something real going on in there. Do dogs feel depression? Do Minecraft dogs feel depression? We will never know. So, as the red internet told me to do, I must punch a tree. Already we are engaged in a struggle of man versus nature. It's as I scroll over this on my computer screen, it identifies the... I have apparently taken inventory. Taking inventory is something much of Western society ought to learn how to do. This wood I am carrying is currently spruce wood. Spruce are tall, majestic trees emblematic of the truest, grandest parts of nature. And as you can see, our unnamed protagonist, emblematic of the entirety of humanity, is destroying one for his own benefit. Now, as you can see, I am playing as one of the game's kind of monsters, a creeper engaged in a human suit. I collect the wool and the meat that was carried by the sheep in the game, slaughtered by the dogs. If you have ever looked a chicken in the eye with great intensity, you will see how stupid they are. I hate chickens. Now, this wood I have captured is emblematic of my struggle against the rest of society and the dark inner human psyche that we all carry. I craft this spruce into planks, and then into a crafting bench, which when I can make my house and begin the slow, long, painful war of society against nature. This pig looks at me without focusing. Does this mean it is stupid? We do not know, and we will never know. Who knows what can go on inside the head of a pig? Pigs are actually quite intelligent creatures as opposed to chickens, but not quite as intelligent as bulls. As we chop down this crafted table, we are returning the landscape to its pristine state. As we traipse about the woods, our own darkest, deep human fears threaten to engage us, and we feel crawled and bowed over this existential dread. I put down my bench once again and decide to make a pickaxe. We are already representing this early beginnings of human society on a massively isolated scale. As I construct my rudimentary wooden tools, I see in myself parallels of the rest of humanity. Digging in the dirt, I am reduced to nothingness, a worm in the great foundation of life. Hopefully someday I will gain the privilege enough to feast upon the carrion of fallen great monsters and beasts. But today is not that day. Today is the day I use a pixelated pickaxe to dig pixelated stone, to make a pixelated stone pickaxe. This landscape is reminiscent of my home in Bavaria, although I do not go there much anymore, preferring to live in Los Angeles where I can get distributors. And I have received an upgrade. This achievement is obviously an attack at the Apple Corporation, encouraging us to get further upgrades of our iPhones and iPads. And so I return to the mines. It is unknown what I hope to find down there, although, with some luck, I might discover riches and carry on the capitalist tradition of Western society. This landscape is forcibly reminding me of the escapades of Tim Treadwell, a man I interviewed, or rather talked about in my documentary Grizzly Man, who thought he could brave himself against the Alaskan wilderness, but ultimately failed, and then was chomped on by a bear. In a horrific incident, a camera on the scene recorded his death. I had the privilege to listen to that scene, and it only confirmed my suspicions that humanity is doomed from the very beginning. That appears to be all there is to this game, although I can break leaves and destroy this very pristine wilderness which was formed in by lines of code, created by a man nobody cares about. I have been Werner Herzog, and this has been Minecraft.